here's an incandescent bulb. You know, they've been with us over 100 years. We started out with first carbon filament lamps, and then around 1910, tungsten filament lamps. And we're still with tungsten filament lamps. And they have several advantages, several disadvantages. The advantages are that they're inexpensive, for one. And for two, they give a nice color rendering. Objects lighted by them look good. So they're excellent for restaurants, houses, things like that. They don't need any auxiliary gear, which means you can plug them straight into household current and run them. You don't need a ballast, so there's no losses from a ballast. And they have a decent life. Some of them are longer life than others, but most are about 1,000 hours. The disadvantages are they're not the most efficient light source there is. In fact, only about maybe 10% of the energy makes light, and the rest makes heat. How it works, it's a very simple principle, incandescence. All it is you have a material, whether it be carbon or tungsten, tungsten's a metal, that you place inside of a glass bulb and you seal it either in a vacuum or you make a vacuum, then you fill the space with a gas like argon or a mixture of argon and nitrogen, and you pass current through this material, which is really a fine wire. And it heats up. It's a resistor. In other words, the current can't pass through it easily. So when the current tries to pass through the wire, it forces its way through and it heats up the wire trying to do it. And in that case, it creates photons, which is light, and also it gives off radiant heat energy as well, which is actually another form of light, infrared energy. The reason why the filament is sealed in a bulb is because if it were exposed to the air, it would burn up in a few seconds because it runs at such high temperatures. So by putting a vacuum in the bulb like the old Mazda lamp has, it keeps the filament away from the air so it doesn't burn out. But with today's light bulbs, you fill the bulb with gas, and the gas exerts a pressure on the filament when it's in operation and makes it last longer, and it can run at a higher temperature and thus produce more light more efficiently without shortening the life of the bulb. So that's the object of putting a gas inside the bulb. Plus it reduces blackening of the glass because the blackening goes to the highest part of the bulb. If it's base up, it'll be here. If it's horizontal, it'll be here. And if it's base down, it'll be here. So that the whole bulb doesn't blacken like a vacuum bulb does, and the bulb will maintain better light output throughout life, which is another advantage of gas filling. Thomas Edison from USA and Sir Joseph Swan from England. And they both hit on the idea of a high resistance filament at the same time. Neither copied either's idea. Both had their own unique contributions as far as bulb designs, filament designs, bases, etc., etc. In fact, in England, the light bulbs ended up being a bayonet base, push-in and turn base, which they still are today. And in USA, it was the familiar screw base. So they had their own individual developments. And then a little bit later on in history, William D. Coolidge was instrumental in developing ductile tungsten for the Mazda lamps, which is still in use to this very day. And not just incandescent lamps rely on it, but incandescent, fluorescent, all kinds of HID lamps, because they all rely on ductile tungsten for either filaments or electrodes. So He developed ductile tungsten wire. And then, of course, around the same time, Irving Langmuir came about with the idea of the gas-filled incandescent bulb. And, of course, that was a great contribution for increasing efficiency. He also came up with the idea of coiling the tungsten filament. Instead of the early bulbs with a straight wire filament, they coiled the filament into a compact unit. And eventually, by the 30s, they were double coiling them, which is what this bulb has. And by coiling the filament twice, it makes it very short and much more efficient.
There is scarcely a person living today who is not benefited by Langmuir's researches and discoveries. His creation of the gas-filled incandescent lamp, which turns night into day, is estimated to save the American people $1 million a night.
And another person that's very instrumental, who's one of my favorites, is Marvin Pipkin. He's the fellow that invented both the inside frosted bulbs that were etched on the inside to reduce glare from the bulbs, which some companies still manufacture to this day, and the soft white bulbs. And they're coated on the inside with silica to diffuse the light, with only about a 3% loss of light output, 10% at the most in some lamps, but usually around 3 to 5%. So that was probably one of the last greatest developments in the incandescent bulb that is still with us today.